Greetings and salutations to them. My name is Somarinoa. Welcome back to Somarinoa Plays, part 6 of Little Nightmares 2. Last we left off, we had entered the Black Tower. So here we go. As a heads up, I actually had to stop this for a little while because as soon as I finished the last round, I discovered I was bleeding from my nose, which is pretty uncommon for me. So it just was a weird kind of coincidence. Spooky. Just a maze in here. Didn't think it'd be the first one. It's like that last castle in Super Mario Brothers. It's the tin can door. Store, isn't it? Figured it out. Musical cue. It's this way. Well, why do you have it all the way down there then? Oh. Got you a ducky. Oh, come on, don't make me destroy her little toy. Six. Ooh. Yeah, why did we do that? Ooh. The off ramp. Got caught up on a wall, of course. There's an axe in that door. Really? Oh, man. Ooh. She's fast. So I gotta rush in there, I guess. How am I supposed to do that? Ooh. Jeez. Man, I obviously had to destroy the music box. Um. Can I try to get over here without her hitting me? Nope. She does not like that. Those doors don't seem to be opening, so I must have to fight her here. Like, officially. I'm gonna try this door real quick, though. Yeah, no. Ow. Yeah, she hates that. Wow. Oh, I see what I'm supposed to do. Mm-hmm. I'm taking that. Thank you. Bye. Oop. Should have punched. Ooh, she saw me. Okay. Ooh. Ooh, she can reach through? Oh, okay. So we got to figure out is how to get that axe over there. Ooh, she got me. Ooh, of course he got stuck in a wall. Shoot. I think that's what I have to do, though, is to get down below. Ah. Hate that I can't jump with that thing. Yep, what am I doing? This is gonna take a while, folks. Of course! Damn it! I'm gonna move that fucking block first. If I can. No, it doesn't do anything. I was thinking I could move it because it gets in the way. Hey. She's real fast. See, I'm afraid if I run through there immediately, she's just going to run to where I actually am. Shit. Might have to hit it without her being away from it. Maybe not. This is gonna take a while. Of course. I'm assuming this is the final boss. There we go. I thought I could get closer. Ah! Oh. Go, 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 go. Come on. Ooh. Gosh, run! Yeah. Go. Get up, stupid. Raziel, you are worthy. She let go of us. I mean, I knew this game was going to end on a downer note, but, bruh. Yeah, hey, don't do that. It's gross. Ooh, he's been there a while. Mm-hmm. Achievement unlocked. Signal interruption. So, there you go. That's Little Nightmares 2. It makes sense that you end up being the, I obviously don't know the monster's names, but the executive guy, the man in black, Slender Man, pretty much. Considering you both had the same powers, and he was the only one who had a regular face in the whole game, really, of any of the monsters. I kind of didn't actually end up expecting Six to drop you at the end there. She's shown some pathic tendencies in the past, but things were starting to look up after you saved her from becoming a monster. So yeah, that genuinely took me by surprise. It's also definitely looking like we're dealing with an elder god in this series. Originally of Lovecraft, but they've kind of spread out throughout fiction. I wonder what this is going to mean for Six going forward. I know there's supposed to be DLC. I don't know if it came out with the game or if we had to wait for it. Either way, once it's out, because it says it's downloaded, I think, onto my systems. Loki the associate producer. Oh, he must be a cat. That's pretty good. Lilith, Lenore, and Zelda. So kind of, that kind of puts the whole situation into perspective, that it wasn't just the Maw. The Maw was more of a smaller part to a larger problem. I'm like I said, I don't know where it's going to go forward, you know, assuming that we eventually get a Little Nightmares 3, which is obviously what it's hinting at. I mean, why would they not, really, honestly? Again, like I was saying, I'll play the DLC as soon as it's out, if it's not already out. I don't know anything about it. It just kind of came with the game. And like I said, it says that it's installed, but like the last time, I think it took, what, did it take 8 months or something? That's just a rough estimate for, at least it felt like 8 months for the DLC when you played the Runaway Kid. Seven. I'm still going to call him Seven. That's the name they originally released. Thank you. The first game had a PS at the end, so I'm assuming this one might as well. I'm assuming so the hallway is sort of like a hinting at maybe running towards your destiny as an adult, even though for a lot of us it turns out just to be a nightmare. Assuming that the DLC isn't out quite yet, next I'll probably return to Resident Evil, which I have been playing, and I've been holding off. You guys may have noticed. I mean, by the time you watch this, you won't have noticed, but, you know, if you're looking back, you may have noticed that it took me a while to actually post up my Resident Evil videos, because right now I have 13 in the wings. You know, they've been sitting ready to publish for weeks now, and I haven't because I've been catching myself up on the thumbnail art instead. You know, kind of spoon-fed one of the Minecraft episodes the other day. I'd like to get through my art and then start posting, but I might just end up posting it anyway just to get this out there and just kind of go back. I kind of hate doing that, but... How's everyone's 2021 going so far? Up here it's been... crazy. It's been a little crazy. Not as crazy as last year. Don't get me wrong. It's nothing like last year, but it's still crazy. A little bit. Hopefully it gets better, but, you know, we'll see. Spyros. Problem with this mic right here. It kind of sticks to where it is. Otherwise, this headset's pretty good. I do like the over-the-ear, or around-the-ear, I mean, setting. Looks like the music's gonna crescendo, kind of working its way up to it. But we got a whole other team to go through. Okay. Cool! I got nothing to say. Since it's about halfway through February now, I'll probably return to Resident Evil after I beat the first one, the remake. I think I have the first six on my Steam library, so I'm thinking I can play one every other month. So where do you think Six is going to go in the next game? I'm thinking they're probably going to end up gearing her up to be the next lady. Just kind of what people have been thinking for, the last couple of years, I guess, since the last game came out. Assuming that this is meant to be just a trilogy, excluding, what's it called? Very Little Nightmares, the mobile game, which is a prequel to the original Little Nightmares. Excluding that as a part of a trilogy, I'm assuming what they probably would want to do is kind of expand the world a little more, maybe involve the, The boatman, the ferryman, who I'm surprised they didn't show in the game. I'm assuming he's supposed to be canon. He's from the comics, actually. They also didn't show the bellhop, which is surprising. I would have thought he would have showed up at some point. It also kind of downplayed who was thought to be Six's dad, maybe, in the fan theories at the beginning of Little Nightmares, as the person kind of hanging there. And then the TV shows that body too, hanging there. They kind of downplayed that with a lot of the other bodies that are hanging. Like it's not quite such a big deal. So then that might not be the case. He might not be our dad or anybody important. Even though he was the only one in that first game to be like that. It's also kind of interesting because it showed, obviously it showed Six transforming into an actual monster over time, as it did with Mono. But it also showed, like, simulacrums being made. Like, what was the idea between the twin chefs? Because they got that, their face isn't their actual face. They rub up underneath it and everything. So they're probably simulacrums or golems or whatever you want to call them. So I don't know really where everyone lies in that, monster-wise. So I guess both monsters are equally viable in this universe. Aiken Chen. I wonder what his actual name is. Is it just maybe Aiken? Credits always takes so long to go through. It's like a 15-minute or more process. I think, Halo Reach had like... Oh god, it must have been 26 minutes of credits. Memory of Peter Bader Sweeney, Michael Rudberg. I wonder if they worked on the first game or something. Or maybe died during this production. Tells you what kind of fonts they're using, that's kind of neat. What do we got? Oh, and there isn't a PS at the end of this one. That's interesting. Unless it was like I can't remember, maybe it was like 100% in order to get the PS in the last one. I'm not 100% certain. So we obviously missed a lot of stuff. No one doesn't have any. Alright, so that's our playthrough of Little Nightmares. Tune in next time. We're probably going to play some Resident Evil, would be what I'm thinking, probably. I always have back games I never actually beat that I need to, but this year I'm trying to play through the Resident Evil series. Even though I was also considering playing all my Mega Man clones, because I have a whole bunch of those on Steam. And then I was like, I guess I'll play Resident Evil. And then, of course, a new one came out that's like a sequel to one of the ones that I had, and that would have worked fine. But shucks! All right. I'll see you guys next time here on Somarinoa Plays. Goodbye.